Alright, this is Power Sports 420 and Candy, and I got a comment from a YouTube viewer, Rice Reaper, wants a bigger mess, so here's my mess. Anyway, today is our air raid install. Now, this could take an hour, it could take three. It really depends on how straightforward these instructions are. So, the first thing we need to do is remove this sensor. Nice and easy. Don't want to mess it up. It's kind of expensive. Alright, then we want to remove this. There we go. Nice and easy. Now, I don't want to do anything wrong here, so... Ooh, these instructions are nice. Disconnect the negative battery terminal. Ha! Loosen hose clamps. Carefully depress lock tabs. Disconnect lines. Remove factory intake tube. Alright, simple enough. Whoops. Let's go with one of these, actually. Don't want to drop any parts down in Candy. She wouldn't like that. Now I'm going to keep these clamps in case the ones Air Raid gave me fail, because these clamps are known to fail. So don't just throw them away thinking that the ones that you got from Air Raid are going to be any better, because they might not be. I'm not trying to diss Air Raid, I'm just being realistic. Right? So, luckily the factory put these on in a way that they're easy to get off. My Chevy Blazer, they were like underneath, and that was not fun. So, thank you Ford for that, even though my axle's all rusted up. Bastards. Anyway. Bam, look at that. Easy. Now, I'm gonna put this with the rest of my parts I'm gonna be selling. So, yeah, I'm selling all these parts, by the way. If anybody needs some Mustang parts, I'm selling them. I ain't keeping them. I don't have enough money to keep them. It's just how it is these days, you know. It's freaking supposed to be $5 a gallon this summer for gas. I know, I screamed too. Started crying. It wasn't pretty. Alright. Like I said, factory parts for sale. Cheap. Not that cheap, but cheap. Ooh, is that a K&N filter? It's a K&N filter. Somebody was thinking ahead when they replaced the filter. This is worth some money right here. Just throw it over here. Alright. Blah, blah, blah. Transfer the factory air... Oh, motherfucker. Transfer the factory airbox mounting grommets. Remove the two lower grommets and install them in the inner fender. Remove the upper airbox grommet and steel sleeve and reinstall into the airbox. Oh, no. I hate grommets. Wait, I don't see any grommets. Oh, they're there. Okay. So I need to get that out. That looks like an 8. A 10. Nope, it's a 10. These instructions already are kind of skipping steps here. Looks like a different airbox. That's concerning. And again, I hope the GoPro is oriented correctly so you guys can see. And I got my camera over here. Hopefully give you guys a better view. I can switch between them if I need to. Now it says grommets go back in the fender. And the upper grommet, which I don't see an upper grommet. I only see two grommets. Well, let's do the lower grommets first. Okay. to be careful of those. Now, the upper grommet. I don't see an upper grommet. Oh, no. What? Oh, jeez. This isn't going to be easy, is it? You guys are laughing at me. Ha! Grommets! Ah! Ooh, this is tearing up my skin. I know. I could rip the grommet. I ain't gonna fuck with this shit today. Been through so many days of hell already, I'm just gonna do it. Bam! Alright. Alright, now this goes into the new box. I'm assuming right here, because it's the only hole that I can see. Now, I did a, I don't remember what brand it was on the Chevy Blazer. Those grommets were ridiculous. Like the internal air temperature sensor grommet. Oh, fuck that shit. These aren't so bad. Probably because they're brand new. Alright. And push that little metal piece back in. Bam. There we go. And install the box, it says. Do this carefully. Make sure those grommets are in place and back in. This is going to be quick. This might be the shortest video so far. Well, the headlights are going to be the shortest video, but those technically aren't in. Headlights don't look like a short video at all, actually. Now that I look at them. Oh, wait. Do I have to remove this box to get to the headlight? Should I just do the headlights now? Crap. It looks like I have to remove this box to get to the headlights. Alright, guys. Change plans. Let's do the headlights. Where did I put them? No, I don't know which ones are the correct ones. Because Silver Star's application guide is incorrect. But I'm assuming it's these. Yeah. Yep. Alright. Now, you cannot touch these with your hands. I'm sure you guys know that. Please God, I hope you guys know that. What's it telling me? How do I open? Oh, crap. Might have more of a problem opening these than anything else. What? Is this thing high? How am I supposed to open it? Really? What the fuck? Where's my trusty screwdriver? You gotta be kidding me. How do you open this? Is this a joke? Some kind of sick joke, isn't it? Ow. Ow! Stab myself. Okay. I think this is just a sick joke. Watch the light bulbs be fake. How do you open this? Apparently it was taped. Thanks for telling me that. Come on, guys. I told you you're supposed to shout out. Be like, damn it, Power Sports. It's taped. Can't you see that? Alright, now I cannot touch these with my fingers or I will ruin them. And they didn't come with cotton swab or alcohol swabs because they're douchebags. So, do not touch on anything, actually. That's sketchy. Question is, how did these old, cheap-ass ones come out? Like that? I think. I'm confused. No instructions or nothing from Silver Star, so that's nice of them. I think it's just stuck in there. Yep. Oh, nope. Oh, shit. Uh-oh. That's not good. I just broke that. Oh, fuck. Oh, man. Oh, fuck. Oh, shit. Is that gonna stay on? Well, shit. I might have to go get that repaired now. Come on, don't tell me this is the wrong bulb. The fuck? Apparently one of them is larger than the others. There we go. So how do I twist that into place without fucking... It's not all the way in. Damn it. Well, this is a problem. Let's take that out for a minute. Fucking hell. If I can't get that in. Alright. Do the other headlight now. Remember, do not touch the headlight. That is so important. It's way back there. How are you supposed to do this? Especially without touching it. The other question is, how does this... And it broke again. Well, fuck. Now, how do I get that bulb back in there without touching it? This isn't gonna be easy, is it? Okay, which one's the bigger one? I gotta figure that out too. The big hole is this way. Alright. Okay. Oh, this is so tedious. Come on. No. What the fuck? Come on. I don't understand why it's not. There we go. The question is how to get it to turn. Because it ain't fucking cooperating. Oh, that one turned way easier than the other one. Alright, now where'd my plug go? Oh crap. There it is. Alright. Let's put this. Don't ever come disconnected because that little clip broke. Guess if I have to get it fixed, I will. Back to the air raid. Man, these are crap compared to the ones I just bought. So, go. Simple. Alright, that's in there. Now what? Now! Did I chuck my mass airflow sensor? Yes, I did. I'm intelligent. Where is it? What? Uh-oh. Oh, I'm really confused now. I unplugged it from somewhere. Where'd I unplug it from? There it is. Oh, they're Torx. Oh, shit. Where's my Torx sockets? Uh-oh. What? I had a whole thing of Torx sockets in here. Oh, hell. Fuck no. Where'd the Torx go? Please be the right size. Oh my god, it's the right size. The luck of that. I have a whole Torx set somewhere, I just don't know where. This mass airflow sensor is expensive. You gotta be careful with it. I mean, you gotta be really careful with it. Very expensive. The fact that I chucked it does not help. At all. Now it wants me to use... Wow, those aren't even magnetic. That's so cheap. It wants me to use Button head screws, it says. $8.32. Assuming that would be the small ones. Oh, look, it came with a Torx. Ha! Wow. I never would have seen that. I believe those are the 832s. Yep. Uh-oh. Oh, which way is up? Oh, fuck. Says this way. So this little down arrow goes down, I'm assuming. Of course it didn't supply me with these. That makes sense. Alright guys, we are back. I'm just having another one of those down days, so I took a little break, got a chocolate banana smoothie courtesy of my Ninja Blender. Oh, that's good. And right now we are trying to find an Allen wrench that fits these. I think it may have given me American bolts on a car that uses metric. The fuck? Yeah. Well, that's fucking dumb. Thanks a lot, Air Aid, you fucking idiots. Don't you know Fords are metric? I didn't know Fords were metric, but you guys should know that. It's your fucking job to know that. There we go. So now, question is, how tight does this go? It's into plastic, so I'm assuming not too tight, but then again, we don't want this vibrating and getting bad readings. That seems pretty good. So basically a full turn after snug. All right. Hopefully that's the right way. It looks like it. Air goes in, gets measured. It's the way it looks on the instructions, so. Now install the grommet and fittings, and since this is a manual, we don't need this. We need the plug. So, grommet first. I hate grommets. Fucking hate them. Oh man, that was so easy compared to normal. It ain't in all the way yet. Come on. Yeah. What the hell? Get your ass mounted. Alright. Now. Oh my god, how am I supposed to. Damn! That is one tight. Holy crap, I can make a really dirty joke. Fuck, that bitch is tight. Fuck. Holy shit. Man, I almost had it. My hands are getting all sweaty. It is a humid day. It ain't even hot out. It's just humid. You know, one of those shit days. Oh man, I scratched that. Oh my god, come on. What the fuck? Alright, let's try it this way. That's working. Gotta put all my fucking body weight. Fuck you. Oh, that was working. It just isn't gonna be easy. Got it. Oh, shit. It ain't even in all the way. There we go. Wow, that was a unnecessary bitch. Alright. Now this thing. I don't know if you guys can see what I'm doing or not. I'm not even gonna bother with a wrench on this. So I guess the auto, this would be the breather for the auto. And this is, that big one's the crankcase breather, I'm assuming. I don't like how they have this here, because that's just a turbulence, you know, it creates turbulence, so I need to screw this in all the way. Try to minimize the turbulence it creates. Wish they had a separate one for manual, but that would be expensive. Alright. Alright, slip the hump hose and hose clamps onto the tube. Slide, blah, blah. Leave the hose clamps loose, of course. Slide. I like how they're like, oh, just slide it on. Bam, pop, it pops on, doesn't slide on. Someone at the factory tightened this too much. Alright, leave them loose. Good advice. Now what? Okay, so it says in here first, and then onto the throttle body. Wait, it's joking, right? I think that's too tight. Uh-oh. That's not good. You know what, fuck it, I'm gonna do it this way. still too tight. Can't get much looser. Alright, this one's gonna have to come off completely. It's way too small. Let's try that. Man, what the hell? Did I get it? I think I finally got it. Holy crap. That is something else. Uh-oh. I got it. Alright, so that was an exceptional... Damn it, seriously? It didn't even go on. Shit, I remember to hit record on this. Yeah. Oh, come on. What the fuck? Okay. We're gonna have to do this a different way. Pull this back out. We're gonna do this a completely different way. So it obviously isn't working right. Sweating my balls off out here today. Whew. Okay. So. Man, this fucking thing just doesn't want to go on. Holy shit, Air Raid, fuck you. Get the fuck on there. Man, it just doesn't want to go on. You guys can see it stuck over here. Ow. Well, that was probably not a good idea. It worked. Not the best idea, but it worked. Okay. Alright. this has got to go back on. Now, this is something you have to check daily for a week, and then weekly for a month, and then monthly. These will come loose, they will vibrate, they will, all kinds of fun things just to piss you off, basically. Alright, so make sure it's on the rubber, then tighten her up. The reason why I'm tightening this one is because it was so hard to get on, I don't want it to slip off. Okay, now the other one, I'm gonna do these bolts first before I do the rest. Holy shit. Man, I am sweating to death. Come on. Oh, I hate you. Seriously. Fucking hell. There we go. Oh, I definitely need a shower after this. I'm soaked. Nice cold shower. Alright, now it's in the plastic, so we don't want to tighten it too much. Alright. So that's done, so we can put this back on. Can put this back on and lock it. Hope that sensor's the right direction. Now we can tighten this. And again, this is something you have to check daily for a week, weekly for a month, and then monthly forever. That's just how it is. Okay. Ah, crap. Okay. Oh my god. Alright. Alright, filter next, it says. Filter's been tightened down. Somebody in the factory trying to play games with me. Alright. Okay. I want this filter on all the way. Don't want any leaks. That would be devastating. Alright, so I'm gonna hold this against here and tighten. And again, every day for a week, every week for a month, every month from then on. Alright, no exceptions. Okay. Last things last, weather strip. Says this way. And they were right online. The weather strip does not perfectly seal off the box, but I have a feeling it does enough. This thing to be even the slightest bit loose. And this is something you can check too. I don't know how often you're supposed to check it, but probably the same every day for a week, every week for a month, every month from then on. Just keep it checked. Make sure you have a good seal on your intake. So. Okay, now let's see what it sounds like, shall we? So now we gotta check for leaks again. Real quick, make sure nothing's leaking. That was loose. That was loose. That was loose. See? Check for leaks. Alright. Now, I'm not gonna film anymore. I'm done. Peace out, guys. Come back to you later.